Hello everyone, my name is Kehinde Olalere. I'm a Canadian immigration lawyer. I'm also a partner at Olalere Law Office, a Canadian-based immigration law firm. I work with my twin brother Taiwo Olalere, he's also a Canadian immigration lawyer. Today I'm going to be speaking about the impact of COVID-19 on Canadian immigration and how you can benefit from it. Over the last few months, COVID-19 pandemic has affected international travels, and that has affected the number of new immigrants to Canada. The Immigration Department, a few months ago, announced that they want to bring in 1.2 million new immigrants to Canada.
I have an announcement to make today, and it's good news. Canada will be accepting 1.2 million new immigrants to Canada. 1.2 million new immigrants to Canada over the next 3 years. So in 2021, Canada will be accepting over 400,000 people. 2022, Canada will be accepting over 400,000 people. 2023, Canada will be accepting over 400,000 people. This is the largest increase in the number of immigrants that will be accepted into Canada within the last 100 years.
In order for them to meet these targets, we predicted that they would have to come up with flexible immigration programs. Otherwise, there's no way they can meet these immigration targets. With all the embassies working at low capacity, with the offices in Canada also working at limited capacity, there's no way they could meet that target. So they will have to come up with flexible immigration programs, innovative changes to processing of the applications, and that is already happening. We predicted that the points that is going to be used to select people from the express entry pool is going to drop. That happened a few weeks ago, and people that already applied, submitted their expression of interest, were able to get an invitation to apply. So if you didn't submit an expression of interest, you just missed out on that good one. Another prediction we made was that they would have to come up with flexible programs that would enable people to also migrate to Canada too. And that's already happening too. With regards to Hong Kong, the Immigration Department already came up with some initiatives there too to help people from Hong Kong migrate to Canada. We also predicted, and this happened this week, that the Immigration Minister would have to come up with ways to either regularize the status of people that are living illegally in Canada, or they will have to come up with ways for international students, people that have already graduated from our schools here in Canada, how they're going to be able to apply for permanent residence. Because those people, their plans were disrupted with COVID-19. They weren't able to find jobs sometimes, or they're not working at full capacity and things like that. So this week, the Immigration Department issued out a number of policies, but I'm going to focus on two policies. One policy focused on international students who recently graduated from Canadian institutions, post-secondary institutions. So if you just recently graduated around January 2017 up to the current time, you may be able to benefit from this particular new policy. So it's very important. There are very specific eligibility criteria. So contact us to schedule a consultation. And if you end up deciding to hire us, we'll be able to represent you on such an application. But there are going to be specific eligibility criteria. It's important that you know them before you spend a lot of money pursuing such an application. Another policy that came out is for those people that are also temporary residents that have Canadian work experience in essential occupations. So if you worked in an essential occupation, you have Canadian work experience, you have temporary resident status in Canada, and you meet other eligibility requirements, you may be able to apply for permanent residence from within Canada. The Immigration Department is really working hard to come up with ways to allow people that are already inside Canada apply for permanent residence, because travel across countries now is very restricted. There's a lot of lockdowns around the world. So the Immigration Minister is focusing a lot now on people that are already in Canada. If you remember, we did a video a couple of months ago about people who were refugee claimants that worked in as frontline healthcare workers. Those people too are already applying for permanent residence, and we are already getting good results for them. So don't miss out on this opportunity. It's a temporary policy. It has a start date and an end date. It's probably going to start on May 6th, according to the policy for both of those policies I just described a little bit now. It's going to start on May 6th. The effective date is May 6th. So you should be consulting with us sometime in the next few days to see whether you meet this eligibility criteria and how you can benefit from it. This is a piece of good news this week. We're so happy to share it with you and let you know about it. It's very important that you contact us as soon as possible. There's a quota, so there's a certain number of people that are going to be allowed to apply under these particular policies. So if the numbers are reached, then you just missed out on your opportunity. You don't want to miss out on that because you don't know what the next policy is going to be or when the next policy is going to be implemented. COVID-19 has really impacted everyone, including us. We've limited number of contacts, face-to-face contacts, so that we, you know, social distance is very important. Keep that in mind. All of us have responsibility to help deal with the spread of COVID-19. Don't forget to wear your mask. Social distancing is very, very important. Follow your local rules. Wash your hands. Very, very important. And stay safe. Okay? Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you again. If you haven't subscribed yet to this YouTube channel, please do so. Click on the notification bell as well so that you can know when we put in our new videos for you to watch. Okay? Thank you. See you again next time. Life is a winding road, no telling where it goes. Driving through days and nights, won't stop for traffic lights. And I really wanna know, really wanna know, if I'll ever figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. Say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high, even if the sky is falling down.